Welcome to Mr. Rogers' class. In today's lesson, we're going to be learning how to compare and order integers, or positive and negative whole numbers, including zero. Now, the way that I remember how to compare and order integers is by using temperature. How cold are you? And how warm are you? That's the same way we think about comparing and ordering integers. Now, what I have over here is a map of the state of Alaska and a few temperatures taken for a few cities within Alaska. So, for example, we have Juneau at 10 degrees Fahrenheit, Kodiak Island at negative 15 degrees Fahrenheit, Unimak at 2 degrees Fahrenheit, and so on. Now, the way that you can remember on how exactly do I order an integer, because I guess it can get a little confusing. Look at Barrow up here, 35 degrees, but there's a negative sign in front of it. Is that bigger or smaller than positive 2 degrees Fahrenheit? The easiest way that I remember how to do this is, let's say that you were actually in the state of Alaska and you didn't have a jacket. Now, if you like warm weather like me, what you're going to want to do is stay in the warmest place possible. That is going to be your highest integer. So, for example, you can look at Unimak with 2 degrees Fahrenheit. That's actually a lot warmer than Barrow at negative 35 degrees Fahrenheit. So you can imagine being at negative 35 degrees near the Arctic Circle is freezing. That's the same concept as ordering an integer. Now over here on this T-chart, what I've done is I've listed the cities in ABC order and their degrees. Now what you'll be given is a list of numbers, and the question will say, please order these integers from least to greatest. Now, instead of thinking of it from ordering them from least to greatest, what I would do is imagine yourself in a state like Alaska, and that those numbers aren't actually numbers, but they're degrees of Fahrenheit. And what you're going to want to do is order them from coldest to warmest, even though the question is asking for least to greatest. So let's do that now. On this list, let's find the coldest temperature. We'll go through, and the number that stands out, as we discussed earlier, is Barrow at negative 35 degrees Fahrenheit. It is so cold in Barrow. If you didn't have a jacket, you would not want to be outside in Barrow, Alaska. So what I'm going to do right here is write the lowest or least integer in this set of integers. It is negative 35. Now I'm going to cross that off because we've used it and move on. Now let's find the next coldest temperature. The next coldest temperature, negative 17. That's going to be pretty cold. Write that there, cross it off the list, because we've already used it. Moving on. Look at Anchorage. Well, actually, that's pretty warm, because it doesn't have a negative in front of it. So I keep looking. Oh, I've got two negatives here, 10 and 15. Negative 10 and negative 15. Well, obviously, Kodiak at negative 15 degrees is going to be colder than Juneau at negative 10 degrees. So our next lowest integer is negative 15. I'm going to cross it off the list because we've already used it. And I would think that you would want to use this strategy of crossing numbers off a list after you've used them as well. Now our last negative number is Juneau, negative 10. Now we're at least into positive territory. It is still below freezing and Fairbanks, Anchorage, and Unimak. But what we need to do now is figure out which one is the coldest. Again, Fairbanks, 1 degree. Let's do that one. Unimak, 2 degrees. And finally, Our warmest temperature in Alaska is in Anchorage, 6 degrees. Cross that off the list. So to review, when you're asked to order an integer from least to greatest, instead of thinking of it from least to greatest, what I would do is think of it from coldest to warmest. And the way to do that is to list them out with the biggest negative numbers as the coldest temperature, of course, and the highest positive numbers as the greatest or warmest temperatures. Thank you very much for your attention, and thanks for visiting Mr. Rogers' classroom.